come out to church in the evening and to see the lights on the trees and the candles, to see the joy in our kids' faces and the childlike joy in the faces of those who are more mature, God, as we consider the marvelous coming of your Son, Jesus. We ask that you would help us, God, during this time, through the Holy Spirit, experience this message afresh, that even though there's so much tradition and so much that's familiar, God, that you would just wow us, that you would just bring something to us tonight that lets us know once again that what a gift it is that you have come here. God, I pray for each person in this room, for the joys and the concerns that we carry in our hearts. And I ask that through the power of the Holy Spirit, you would help us hold worship to you. I ask also, God, that you would hear us now as we pray the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. I would like to invite the Giles family forward to light the Advent candles.
Today is Christmas Eve. Tonight we light the four purple candles. We also light the center white candle. The first Sunday, we lit the candle of hope. The second Sunday, we lit the candle of love. The third Sunday, we lit the candle of joy. The fourth Sunday, we lit the candle of peace. Today, we also light the center candle. This candle represents Jesus. When we light this candle, we remember Jesus' birth. Our waiting has ended.
When we look at the second candle, we remember that God sent Jesus to give us hope, peace, joy, and hope to all peoples. Outside of Bethlehem, the shepherds saw a great light and heard the voices of angels. They traveled to the manger and saw the baby Jesus. Far away from Bethlehem, wise men saw a star in the sky. They followed the star and were filled with joy when they found Jesus. They remind us that the gift of Jesus was not for the people in one place, but for all people.
I'd like to invite all the kids to come up to the front. The first verse is just going to be the children.
Thank you. Matthew
chapter 1, verses 8 through 23. This is how the birth of Jesus the Messiah came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was faithful to the law and yet did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel.
Issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judah, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them.
Thank you.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger."
Thank you. he, she, it, is. I am. Hi. Can you show me the way to the beach? Towel. Breakfast. Fork. Bread. I love you. You are perfect. I'm gonna kill you. I love you. You are perfect.
My face. And what is it?
Suitcase. Slippers. Toothbrush. Passport.
Big dog.
I am.
The incarnation, my friends. It, in a Polish commercial, we see the incarnation. We see God's desire to come and tell us that he loves us in person. Not content just to write letters, not content just to have people tell stories about a distant and faraway God, but that God would come here himself, learn our language, and tell us that he loves us. This is the greatest Christmas gift that has ever been received, that very first Christmas, sending God here to say, I love you, in our own language, to see that face to face. And so the question is for us this Christmas, being people who have received this gift, this understanding that God has come here in the flesh to say, I love you. Now the question is, what do we do with that gift? Except to pass it on. How are we going to pass that gift of incarnation on? What language are we going to be willing to learn to speak to someone who needs to hear about it? What place will we be willing to go so that someone can hear that God loves them too? The greatest gift of Christmas ever, even for you guys sitting here in the front row thinking about Xboxes, or whatever you think of. The greatest gift is God coming to speak our language, to meet us in person and say that he loves us. Will you go and share that gift, that incarnation, so that someone else can hear that God loves them too? Amen. Luckily, we have another chance to share a gift right now, because it is time for our offering. When we give these gifts, we understand that they're a response to God's generosity to us already. And so we will pray now for our offering. Lord God, it's an astonishing thing to think that you would come so far to be with us and to tell us that you love us. But we hear you and we believe you. And we thank you for working with us as flawed and as imperfect as we are. We ask that you would receive this offering as an expression of our thanks for all that you have done in the world, and we ask that you would anoint us as well to be an offering to this world, that we may show your love, the incarnation, to others who need to hear it so much. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you. In the book of Luke, chapter 2, verses 13 through 14, suddenly a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests."
At this time, I would like to invite forward friends of ours from the Church of All Nations. For 2 years now, we have had worshiping in the parlor on Sunday morning. A group started out small and has been growing over time, led by Pastor Johnson Irungu. They are Episcopalian. Johnson is an Episcopalian pastor from Kenya. And we're really blessed and privileged to have them singing and praying right down the hall during our worship service. So I'd like to invite them forward. I asked them for a traditional Kenyan Christmas carol, and so they will sing O Holy Night.
Singing in French and in English. I know she said Kenyan, but because we are a Church of All Nations, I'm like, let's put a spin on it. So French and English.
La tâche en Et de son père
Aldersgate has a many generations tradition of singing Silent Night arranged in a circle around the outside of the sanctuary. So I would like to encourage you, as you are able, to form a circle around the sanctuary.
Thank you. now for the last lesson, which is from the first letter of John, chapter 4, verses 7 through 9. Dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who has been born of God knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, because God is love. And this is how God showed his love among us. He sent his one and only Son into the world that we might live through him.
At this time, I would like to invite you to attend worship here tomorrow morning at 10:30. We are having a brunch service. You may wear your pajamas. That will be at 10:30 tomorrow morning, Sunday morning. A week from today, we will not be meeting at Aldersgate for services. We will be joining Union Congregational Church on Saturday, December 31st. Saturday, December 31st at 11 a.m. for lunch and for a worship service. And regular worship services will resume here on January 8th at 10:30 in the morning. For now, let me wish you a very Merry Christmas.
Rachel, we have one more.